I don't know. I gotta tell you. The truth is, I don't have sex even when I want to, even when I was thinner, because I'm a Christian. So now I just eat ice cream. Praise the Lord. Okay, anyway. So you guys, I don't know if you heard that they're actually letting a lot of inmates out of the prisons because we can't afford to pay for them anymore. A lot of overcrowding. And the good news is, you guys, this opens up the dating world. Woo! Oh, yeah! Okay, anyway. And it also helps us comedians with a lot of good material. But also, it's another reason to become part of the Fatness Protection Program. So if any of you want to start overeating, you know who to hang out with. That's right. I have to tell you, you guys were talking about dating, and this guy, he wanted to date me, and he wanted to go eat. And I was like, I'm white. We don't eat in front of guys. And the reason, you know, I don't know, I had my reasons. One of them might be because I have food allergies to dairy, garlic, almonds, and casein, which is what they use when they try to make non-dairy substances. So in other words, I'm allergic to everything I love. And I'm an addict, so just because I'm allergic doesn't mean I'm going to not eat it. So what I didn't want to have happen is what happens when I eat, which is my nose starts running. And especially if it's really good salsa or something, you know? And then because my nose won't stop running, I just take tissues and I start putting them, plugging up my nose. And unless we're really good friends, it might freak you out.
Huh?
Like on a first date. Like, I just can't imagine a guy wanting to go down on me after that. Anywho, so whatever. Alrighty, so... And Solange was talking about wanting to be compensated for sex. I have to tell you something, Solange. I was raised with morals. That say that bad girls get paid for it. And good girls do volunteer work. And you're right. It's like, my God. Imagine if we got paid every time. I'd have like at least $17. Woo! All right. Okay, anyway. Gosh. And then I think Cece was talking about porn. Thank you very much for bringing up porn. Yeah, when I was younger, I really liked gay male porn. Because at least you saw some cock. Like a lot of cock. Because predominantly porn is made for lone masturbating heteros. And I don't like to see a guy where you like only see the cock for a second and then it's like lost in the vag. And you see a lot of boobies and a lot of girls that, you know, faking orgasms. Because when you're a woman, you know. Like, she's not enjoying it, you know. First of all, she's too skinny. Which means she's sickly with a disease called anorexia. Or she's on meth. Yeah, it's pretty much a toss-up. And so she's not enjoying it. And then, especially when the guy ignores her vag to stick it in her ass. Because at least in the vag there's a clit, right? But not in the ass, guys. Okay? And in gay porn, it's honest because they do have a clit in their ass. They've got the prostate, right? So at least they're enjoying it. Anyway, okay. So I used to be into the gay male-on-male thing so I could see a dick finally. And because I was going to all girls' school. And whatever, I was a virgin a long time. And so I was curious. And then as I got older and after I had sex, so I was a virgin watching gay male porn. That's nice. That's really nice. I was also a virgin Phonesex operator. Because I was really repressed, but I wanted like a place to get it all out, but not to actually get diseases. Talk about being the loneliest person in the world. It's like, my real life, you know, virginals friends that I went to, this, you know, really conservative prep school with, they had no idea I was doing the Phonesex, right? And the guys on the line would never believe I was a virgin or that I was 18. They're like, come on, tell me how old you really are. I'd be like, okay, I'm 45. 400 pounds. Got a mustache. Man, do you believe me? I'm like, oh yeah. Anyway. So praise the Lord. So what I found out from that was I was really funny. And yeah, I would crack guys up and the bosses would call me up and say, excuse me, could you talk more sex? Instead of doing all the accents and... Anyway, I loved that I was a stand-up comedian. I really did. Because in those early days of Phonesex, you could have like up to 8 guys call you, so that was an audience. I mean, look, ooh, that's a big crowd. Anyway, so yeah, so fabulousness.